Okay, so we'll start with the second lecture on DFA. Okay, so last lecture we have seen the basic terms, that is alphabet, input alphabet or output alphabet of the finite state machine. Okay, you are able to see the presentation now? Can you see the slides?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So last lecture we have seen about the basic terms about DFA, alphabet, that is input alphabet or output alphabet. It is a set of symbols which are there as an input or output to your machine. And a string is combination of symbols. Then epsilon symbol is indicated as this epsilon symbol, the empty symbol is indicated as epsilon. It's a string without any symbol. And the language is set of words with certain criteria. Then we have seen concatenation, star closure, and plus closure. Okay. Then we have so just have a quick recap of FA. We are on the topic of DFA without output symbols. Okay. What we are doing is that for this FA, there are two types, DFA and NFA. DFA is a deterministic finite automata and NFA is a non-deterministic. In DFA, so we are learning DFA without output symbols, like it is acting as an acceptor or rejector of a string. In this case, your DFA is acting as an acceptor or rejector to a particular string. Okay, so either it will accept or either it will reject. DFA with output symbol, it will generate the output string for the corresponding input string. Okay, it may not, there is no final state as such over here. Okay, so in case of DFA without output symbol, there is a final state and DFA is acting as an acceptor or rejector for the string. And DFA with output symbol, it is going to generate the corresponding output symbol for the input symbol or for the input string, it is going to generate the corresponding output string. Okay, so that is the difference between these two. And there are two types of DFA with output symbol, Willey machine, Moore machine, similar to the machines that you study in DLDA. Okay, then NFA, NFA with epsilon and NFA without epsilon. Okay, so we are on this topic. Okay, I've told you about the application of DFA in compiler construction. Here in this diagram, it is showing that this is a DFA diagram for an identifier of a particular language. Okay, so it is a mathematical model of identifier that is used while compiler construction. Once this diagram is ready, it's very easy to write the program. Okay, for this particular code, for this particular diagram. Okay, and DFA ka, we can have some tools by using them. We can directly convert this diagram into the particular code, or you can easily automate it. Okay, then we studied about dead state, that sometimes we need dead state in case of DFA, and we say that when the machine reaches to dead state, it cannot go anywhere else. It will stuck over there, and machine is in the hang state. So the definition of DFA is, it is the combination of five elements Q, sigma, delta, Q0F, where Q is equal to set of states. You have to by heart this, each and every problem of DFA, you have to write down the definition, 1 or 2 marks for writing the definition. So Q is a set of states, sigma is a set of input symbols, and both the states are finite states. Okay, delta is a transition function, which shows the state transition. Okay, then like how the states are transited. Q0 is the initial state belonging to capital Q, and capital F is a subset of Q. So this is important. It is a subset of Q. So this symbol indicates it is a subset, and it is a set of final states. Means this subset contains all the final states. It is a subset of capital Q, but it is a finite set of final states. Okay, this way you can write down. and you have to draw the diagram and table that as per I told you. And the main important thing to remember about DFA is that in case of DFA, from the state exactly one outgoing symbol, outgoing transition is there for every input symbol. For example, for S0 there is one outgoing transition for one symbol, and from S0 there is one outgoing transition for zero. So like this for every state. Okay, so drawing DFA in the initial state is very easy, but once you are familiar with this designing problems, drawing DFA NFA is easy. Now we'll we have solved three problems, so we'll take simple problem for today in the beginning. Okay, if possible, by looking at the problem, you try to draw the diagram on your own on paper, and then you verify the answer with me. Okay, if you are confident about drawing the diagram. Okay, the question is now, today's first question of designing DFA is that design DFA that accepts the strings ending with zero. Okay, so what, just read the statement properly, just spend some time on reading the designing statement, and then you need to interpret it properly. Once your interpretation is correct, your design is correct. So you have to design, I'm just thinking now how to solve the problem, designing of DFA which accepts strings ending with zero. So that means the string should end with zero. So when we are solving the problem, we need to, the first step is to write the definition. Second step is identify sigma. Sigma I can identify here. Here there is a mistake here. It is 0, 1. Okay, sigma is 0, 1, and the initial state is Q0. That's what I have identified. Now I have to identify the minimum string. So if you remember, I told you that it is a trial and error method. Drawing this diagram is a trial and error method. So you need to verify your answer properly. First step is mostly you need to draw the diagram for the minimum string, minimum length string. So in this case, if it is if the string is only zero, it should be accepted. Okay, so because the string is ending with zero, so minimum length string is zero. So what I'll do is that I'll first draw the diagram for minimum length string. Okay, so with zero I'll say that okay, it is going to the final state. So only zero.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah.
Your screen is invisible.
That presentation screen is not visible. Okay. So you should have told me. Because I'm not able to see the chat. If I'm presenting, no. Sometimes I'm not able to visible see the chat. Okay, I'll share the window and then I'll try. Now. Oh, is it visible?
Yes, ma'am. Now it's visible.
Okay. So my problem is.
It's visible now.
Okay. Now the problem is that I want to design DFA that accepts the strings ending with zero. Okay. So first you write the definition, identify sigma. Sigma should be 0, 1 here. There is a mistake here. And then the initial state is Q0. Okay. Now whenever you are drawing the diagram, you should understand that what should be the minimum length string. Okay, so if the string is ending with zero, I can say that only zero is a string, which is a valid string. Okay, so the language contains the word zero. The zero is belonging to this language, which contain strings which are ending with zero. So okay, so what are the accepted strings? So you prepare this table. So this is a valid input zero. Then with all ones ending with zero is allowed, all zeros are allowed, 0, 1 with three zeros allowed. Okay, so any combination of zeros and ones with zero ending with zero is allowed. And here this last two is accepted, but first two are not accepted. 1, 1 and 0, 1 is not accepted. Okay, so first is take the minimum length string zero and you draw the diagram. So Q0 with 0 going to Q1 is accepted. Now, so your minimum minimum transition wala DFA ka diagram is ready now. Okay. So now you revisit all the states and try to identify missing transitions. So I'll visit Q0. With Q0, I'll see that one outgoing transition is there for 0. And so we need to have one more transition for the symbol 1. Okay. So with 1, where should it go? With symbol one, can you answer by unmuting? With one, where should, where it, if my string is starting with one, is it allowed or not?
Yes, ma'am.
So will it go to the dead state or will it go to any other state?
It should go back to Q0.
Yes, yes, correct. Right, it will remain in Q0 because 1110 is allowed. So it, there will not be a dead state here. This with one, it will remain in the state Q0. So for Q0 with one, it will remain here. And so both the transitions for Q0 are over. Now I'm going to Q1. In Q1 with zero, if it is zero, then it should remain in the final state because if the string is ending with zero, it is allowed. Okay. Now if there is any one, it will go back because with one more zero, it may go to the final state. Okay. So this way you will draw the diagram. Here there is no dead state. Here there is no dead state. With one, it will go back because there can be a string like 1010. So if it is 1010, then it should be accepted. So for that, it will go back. Now you try with the rejected input 11. With 11, it is remaining in Q0. With 01, it is remaining in Q0. So that is not allowed. These two strings are allowed. 0110. So 0111 and 0. It's going to the final state. So like this, you verify the answer. Okay. I think this was a very simple problem and you don't have any issues in this. Then the next step is to draw the transition table from this transition diagram. I'll just once repeat this transition table. You just see this Q, you write down all the states here in this column. First column, write down all the states Q0 to Q1. Show the initial state, show the final state. And then for the input 0 and 1, you show the next state. So here, this is a previous state. And this Q0 is a previous state. And with 0 input, the next state is Q1. That's what we are telling. Okay, so prepare the transition table, prepare the final answer, and then the write down the final state. I think this slide is incomplete. Okay, but just ignore this type 4, which is there in the slide. Now remember what I'm teaching you. I'm teaching you some new concept here. Okay, so this new concept is you need to remember this delta. Okay, we are writing this delta in the definition Q into sigma is equal to Q, where Q is a previous state. Sigma is the input symbol and this Q is the next state. Okay, so this delta, we can write it like this. So this delta is nothing but it is represented in the diagram as well as in the table. All three are showing the same information. This diagram, this table and this delta written as per the equation, all are same. Okay, and if you know this, how to write this, then in the definition, you don't have any problem to write this transition function. You don't have to by heart it. You will be able to remember it if you understand this. And it is very easy. What it is written here, delta, means transition function delta, Q0 with 0 is Q1. Okay, so Q0 with 0 is Q1. So that's what we are writing. This is a previous state. In this state, if the symbol is 0, the next state is Q1. That is the meaning. So you just draw the diagram and you write down this, and then from this you can remember the this transition function, that Q0 belongs to capital Q, 0 belongs to sigma, and Q1 belongs to capital Q. So this, I think, remembering transition function delta and the definition is not an issue now. Okay, so capital Q is a set of states, sigma is a set of input symbols, delta is a transition function, Q0 is the initial state and F is a set of final states. You need to show here it is a subset and Q0 belongs to Q. So this mathematical symbols you need to remember belongs to subset and the transition function. Okay. So I think we have done a proper recap. Now you can just reply me on the chat. Is there any issue in understanding this problem? Any doubts in the previous problem? Okay, so we'll go ahead with the next problem. The next problem is that design DFA that accepts strings such that any number of A's are followed by one B. Any number of A's followed by one B. So just write down what is your interpretation. Any number of A's followed by one B. Identify the minimum length string and write down in chat. Any number of A's followed by one B. Write down the minimum length string. Okay, so this Rahul is saying one. So the correct answer is only B. B is the minimum length string. Any number of A's, that means that there can be zero number of A's followed by one B. And so one B is needed. One B is needed. So the minimum length, so I'll write down the definition of DFA. Sigma is equal to A comma B. Initial state is Q0. And then my minimum string is B, like one B is needed, is the requirement. Okay, so I'll start with drawing initial state Q0. If there are A, any number of A's means it can be zero number of A's or one number of A's or five times or two times or three times or 10 times or 100 times. So if there is a loop like this, means A can be repeated for even zero times. This is the initial state. Machine is in the initial state Q0. If A is for zero times, this loop is not traversed. It will remain there without traversing the loop. If A is there for one time, it will travel for once. Okay. And followed by B. So with B, it will go to the final state. Okay. So this is a minimum diagram that I have drawn. Now I will check what are the missing transitions. So for Q0, both the transitions are done. So Q0 is over. I'll go to Q1. Now in Q1, what will happen for A? What will happen for A in Q1? Reply. For it will be a dead state. Because they are saying that any number of ones followed by one B is a string. So after B, there cannot be anything else. So if after B anything is there, A or B, it will go to the final state. The dead state, sorry. Okay, so I'm drawing here for A or B. After that, if there is anything, then it will go to the dead state, and in the dead state, A and B. So the transitions for Q1 are over and Q2 is over. So see the accepted input. All A's with B is allowed, 2 A's with B allowed, 7 or 8 times A with B is allowed, BAB is not allowed. Then Mrs. String, the language does not accept the string like this. Language accepts the strings which contain multiple A's followed by one B. Okay, then write down the transition table, then the final answer. Q0, Q1, Q2 with sigma, Q0, delta and F. Okay. Any doubt in this? So here it is, any number of A's followed by B. Okay, so we'll see the next problem. Okay, so the next problem is design DFA that accepts strings ending with 2 B's. Strings which are ending with 2 B's. Okay. So first step is to write down the definition and identify sigma. Sigma is equal to A comma B and the initial state is Q0. Okay. Now you tell me the minimum length string. ओके टू बी, स्ट्रिंग एंडिंग विथ टू बी, सो मिनिमम लेंथ स्ट्रिंग इज टू बी. ओके सो आई एम जस्ट राइटिंग, ट्राइंग टू आइडेंटिफाई व्हाट आर द स्ट्रिंग्स विच आर अलाउड. मिनिमम लेंथ स्ट्रिंग इज टू टू टाइम्स बी, एंड स्ट्रिंग शुड वॉट एवर इट इज स्ट्रिंग शुड एंड विथ टू टाइम्स बी. सो माई नेक्स्ट वैलिड स्ट्रिंग इज ऑल एज विथ टू बीज आर अलाउड. Then combination of A's and B's with last two B's is allowed. All B's are allowed. Then two times A with many times of B is allowed. Then any combination of A's and B's ending with double B is allowed. Okay, so these are the valid strings. But if my string is not ending with BB, it is not allowed. So I'm just writing some combination of A's and B's, and at the end it is not. It is ending with small B or AB or BA or AB or AA or AA. Okay, if it is there are four combinations. The string may end with AB or BA or AA or BB. So it should end with double B. So it should not end with AB, BA or double A. So that's why I have written down. Okay, so take 10 strings, around 8 to 10 strings, and make a list. After that, the minimum length string is double B. So draw the diagram for double B. So with B it is going to Q1. With one more B, it is going to Q2. So this is done. My minimum diagram of DFA is done. Now I have to check for the missing transitions. So I'll visit the state Q0. Q0 with A. Now what should happen? Q0 with A. Where should it go? Q0 with A, most of the people are saying Q0. Okay, so Q, yes, it will be Q0. It will not be a dead state because it is allowed. A's are allowed. Okay, if it is starting with A, it should be rejected as a kuch nahi hai. So many A's are allowed. So A ke liye in Q0, it will be a loop. Sorry, my animation is wrong here. With A, it will be, it is remaining in the same state. Okay, so that's what I have done. For Q0. Now I'm going to visit both the transitions for Q0 are done. Now in Q1, if there is any A, in Q1, if there is any A, what should it go? It should go back to Q0. Okay, right. Means you are understanding. With Q1, with Q0, it will go back again because with this A, it will go back, and if so, it can be a string such as A, B, A, and double B. It should be accepted. Okay, if your string is A B A double B, like here it is A B A double B, it should be allowed. So here it will happen A B with A go back, and with two B's go to the final step. Okay, so both the transitions for Q1 are over. Now for Q2 with B, it will remain there because then this will be, if it, the string is all B's, it should be accepted. String with all B's should be accepted. So B, B, B and B for any number of times, it is ending with two B's. So it is allowed. But if there is any A here, in Q2, if there is any A, it will be Q0, correct. It will be Q0. Q2 with A, it will be Q0. Okay. Now, this is trial and error method. I'm just thinking that it is correct, but I don't know. So don't be lazy and see the strings and verify. So for B, right now I'm not going to verify each and everything, but in the exam or whenever you are solving the problems, you always do this, and then only you finalize your answer. Okay. So I'll take one string such as B A B A B A B. So it is B A B A B A and B. It is remaining in Q1, so it is not accepted. Okay. Then I'll take the string AB 4 times B. So if it is 4 times B, B, B and 2 times B. So it is remaining in the final state. So like this, verify the answer and then only finalize. Okay. And then you draw the table with all three. Then final answer and the final state. So final state, showing final state in curly brackets is must. Because it is a set of final states. It can be more than one final state. Okay, now this next problem is little different now. Okay, from the previous problem. Any doubt was there for the previous problem? That was also easy. Okay, so today's first three problems were easy. Now I'm taking some different type of problem. Okay, which is solved by different method. We have done about the divisibility by 3 for FSM, but that was for the decimal numbers. Now my question is that design DFA for a given binary number and check that whether the binary number is divisible by 3 or not. Okay. So in this case, again, I can identify how many states are there in advance. Like I'll say that if the number is divisible by 3, so my remainder can be 0, 1 or 2. So I will be having 3 states. So my capital Q, I can identify. Okay, see the capital Q. I can identify here. Capital Q is a set of states. I can say, I'll write down in my logic that my state with remainder 0 is equal to Q0. Then state with remainder 1 is Q1. Okay, like this, I'll remember. Okay, then... Then what you have to do is that you have to prepare the table. Okay. To solve this particular problem, you just write down all the decimal numbers. Okay, don't be lazy. Take the numbers till 15. Write down all the decimal numbers 0 to 15. Write down the corresponding binary numbers. Okay, so I've written down here for every decimal number this binary numbers. Okay, now whatever is there in green color, all these numbers are divisible by 3. So this is my calculation, my logic for creating DFA. So all these green color cells indicates that the number is divisible by 3. So my state Q0 indicates that the number is divisible by 3. So I'll write down that here. Q0, 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 Q0 for 0, 3, 6, 9, 12, and 15. I'll directly write down Q0. Now for 1, my remainder is 1. And I'll say that by my state Q1 will represent that the number is, when you divide it, the remainder will be 1. So I'm writing Q1, for the numbers 1, 4, 7, 10, and 13. Then I'm writing Q2. Okay, so like this, this is very easy to create. Okay. So create the table. Write down all the decimal numbers, corresponding binary numbers, and the final and the state in which the machine will go after dividing this number. Okay, now once this table is ready, draw the diagram. So my initial state is Q0. Now see the take the first number. Okay, my first number is 0, means any number of 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 for 5 times, 10 times, 3 times, my state is Q0. So by looking at this 0, 0, 0, draw the transition. That 0, 0, 0 ke liye, it will remain in the state Q0. So go on drawing the transitions by taking the numbers from here. And automatically your diagram will be ready. Okay. Now the next number is 0, 0, 1. For 0, 0, 1, it should go to the state Q1. So I'll draw that 0, 0 and 1. It will go to the state Q1. Okay, so I'll draw that. With 0, 0, 1, it is in the state Q1 now. Now my second number is 010. If the input is 010, it should go to the state Q2. So I'll say 01. After that, if there is any 0, the state is Q2. So I'll draw that. The state is Q2. So I have done with first three numbers 012. Okay, 012 ke liye my diagram is done. Now I'm taking the third number. This number, number 3. 3 is 011. For 011, it should remain in the state Q0. So I'll now assume that my string is 0111. So I'll start from here, 0, initial state. Then 0, then 1 may it is going to Q1. Now one more 1 is there. So I have to draw the transition for 1 from Q1. So it will be, you just draw it, it will go back to the state with 1 to Q0. So I have done with 011. So for 011, it is going back in the state Q0. Okay, so this is done now. Now take the next number, that is 4. 4 is 100. So for 100, it should go to the state Q1. So the transition for 0 from Q2 is missing. So I'll draw that. And with so if my input is 100, so input is 100 means in the state Q0, first symbol is 1. So it will go to Q1, second symbol is 0, it will go to Q2, third symbol is 0, it will go back and it is in the state Q1. That's what I have drawn here, 4. Now take the next number 101. 101 ke liye, it should remain in the state Q2. So for 1, 0 and 1, it will remain in the state Q2. Okay. Now I think all the transitions are done. I'm giving different colors to these nodes. So this is a black color where two transitions are there, blue color where both the transitions are done, and green color ka two transitions. Okay. So means my diagram is over. Now for the rest of the numbers, I'm going to verify my answer. Okay, so if it is 6, 6 means 110. It should remain in the state Q0. So for 1, 1 and 0, it is Q0. Okay. Then for 111, it is Q1. So 1, 1, 1, it is Q1. Then 1000, Q2. So 100 and 0 is Q2, verified. Then 1001 should be Q0. So 100 and 1 should be Q0, correct. Then I'll take some other number, 1010, Q1. 101 and 0 is Q1. Okay, I'll take the 14, number 14, that is 1110. So 1, 1, 1 and 0, it is a state Q2, correct. Okay, like this you have to verify your answer. Okay, so this was very easy question, binary numbers. Now I'm going to give you a question in the tutorial where you will have to check that whether the number is divisible by 3 and the number system is ternary number system. So anyone can tell me what is ternary number system? Binary number system, we have two symbols, 0 and 1. For decimal number system, we have 10 symbols, 0 to 9. In ternary number system, how many symbols are there? 0, 1, 2, correct. Vinayak is saying 0, 1, 2. Ternary number system is having 3 symbols. So in the exam, there can be any combination of questions like ternary number system divisible by 3, or binary number system divisible by 5, or ternary number system divisible by 5, or decimal number system divisible by 3, decimal number system divisible by 5. Okay, so if it is a DFA ka diagram, this is the way. Like in the ternary system, you will have to write down the corresponding ternary numbers here. Okay. So these numbers will be made up of 3 symbols, 0, 1 and 2. Okay. So in that ternary number system, can anyone tell me what is 3? Ternary number system. Yeah, Anisha, the Q2 is not a final state because I have copy pasted. No, I forgot to change the final state. Okay. I have created so many slides. So I have checked it thoroughly. But Q2 is not a final state here. I'll change that. Q1 is the final state. Q1 is the final state, or we even and so this is the correct thing. I'll do that afterwards. The final state is Q0. Correct. Q0 is the final state. And then you need to write down it. Okay, so any doubt in this? Okay, so we'll go with the go ahead with the next problem. Am I going very fast? So we can go with the next problem now, or do you want to see the previous problem? Any doubts in the previous problem? You can unmute and you can ask me the problem. Okay, so we'll go ahead with the next problem. The next problem is about designing of DFA that accepts strings with number of A's divisible by 3. Okay, now here they are saying that your sigma is equal to A comma B, and the number of A's are divisible by 3, and here there is and, there is no or, and number of A's are greater than 0. So, can you identify how many number of A's are there? So, in the logic, number of A's is equal to 3, 6, 9. They cannot be 0. The question is DFA that accepts strings with number of A's divisible by 3. Total number of A's in the string is divisible by 3. And number of A's are greater than 0. So, how many, what is the minimum length string? What is the minimum length string? Reply. Okay, correct. Mario, Deepita, Smith. So there are three A's. So there are three A's as a minimum length string. So solve the problem. Write down the definition. Sigma is equal to A comma B. Initial state is Q0. And my logic is saying that number of A's are 3 or 6 or 9 or 12. And there are no constraints on B. B ke bare mein they are not saying anything. So B's are anything. It can be 0 or 1 or 2 or 3, anywhere. Okay. But total number of A's in the string are 3 or 6 or 9. Okay. So right, identify the strings. I'll say that minimum length string is 3 A's are there. Then I'll say that B, then 3 A's, double B, 3 A's. Even it is not mentioned that all these 3 A's should be in the consecutive order. Like here, happen, this string is allowed, but if it is BA, 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 that is also allowed. Okay, so there is no requirement that A's are consecutive A's. So here, 3 A's are there, then B is there in between. So next 3 A's, and then 3 A's, and then 3 A's. Okay, so any combination of total number of B's, any total number of A's anywhere should be divisible by 3. Here, there are okay, so I have created the strings. Here there is only 1A, so not accepted. 2A is not accepted. 2A not accepted. 5A's are not accepted. Okay, 2A's are not accepted. Or 2A's are not accepted. Okay, so these are rejected. So prepare this list. Now start drawing the diagram for the minimum length ka string. So it is AAA. Okay, so I'll say that with Q, with A it will go to Q1. Next A, Q2. One more A. In Q3. Okay, and this is the minimum length string, so Q3 is the final string. Now revisit the diagram, go to the state Q0, identify the missing transition. For B, what should we do now? B ka transition is missing there. So I have identified that. I have to draw in the state Q0 what should be the transition for small b. So reply me for B. B may, yes, correct. It will remain in the state Q0 because it is allowed. It is not a dead state. It is not a dead state. Okay. So with B, it will remain here. Now this state Q0 is complete. Both the transitions are there. Now in the state Q1, identify the transition for symbol B. In Q1, if there is any B, why Q0? In Q1, if there is any B, it is a Q1. Most of the people are saying it is Q1, correct. So it will remain there. And now this Q1 state means that 1A is over. We have to count the number of A's. So if the machine is in the state Q1, means 1A is over. Now it needs two more A's to reach to the final state. Okay, now you need to interpret it like this. Always remember, you interpret it like this, that with 1A it has reached to Q1. Now in Q1, the machine needs two more A's to reach to the final state. Okay, so now both the transitions for Q1 are over. Now in Q2, if there is any B, B ka transition is missing in Q2. In Q2, if there is any B, Q2, Correct. So with Q2, it will remain in Q2. So both the transitions for Q2 are over. Now in Q3, if there is any A. In Q3, if there is any A. Q3 में आ गया ना अभी तो. Now in Q3 both the transitions are missing. So in Q3 if there is any A, what will happen? Divita, Akshay, Sanath, Ayush are saying it is Q0. Okay, so if you are saying that from Q3 it will go to Q0, then three A's are over. With eight is going here. Okay. Now so it is a trial and error method. So you draw the transition in the book. From Q3 to Q0, it's going back. So suppose my string is all A's. So how many A's will be there? 1, 2, 3, 4, then 5, 6, and 7. With 7 A's, it will go to the final state. With 7, it will go to the. So is it right? No, it is not right. So the correct answer is Q1. Correct answer is Q1. Okay. So this way you make the mistake in the exam. Like initially you may feel okay, it has to go to Q0, so draw it. But after drawing it, you just check it whether it is correct transition or not. So if you draw it, then what will happen? 1, 2, 3, then 4, then 5, 6, 7. With 7 as it is reaching to the final state, which is not correct. That means the transition is wrong. So you need to check where to go. Then from Q3 to Q1, if it is with A, then with 2 A's, it will go to the final state. So with for A, it will go back. But for B, it will remain there. If the transition is B, it will remain there because 3 A's are over and any number of B's can be there. And it will remain in the final state. And for A, it will go back in Q1. Okay, now all the transitions are over. You cross-check and verify your answer. So 2 A's, 3 B's, 2 A, and 3 B's. It is remaining in Q2. Okay, I'm taking this another string. 3B, 2A. Okay, so with 3 B's and 2 A's, it is in Q2. Okay, so remember here, if you want to interpret this particular problem, your Q0 is a state which says that number of A's are zero. In the string, number of A's are zero. The state Q1 is saying that number of A's in the string are one. Is one. The state Q2 is saying that number of A's in the string are two. Okay, if you divide it by three, it is two. Then the state Q3 is saying that number of A's from the starting is equal to three. Okay, so this way, this is a complete diagram. Verify the answer, write down the table, and then write down the final answer. So now here I'm teaching you some other concept here. Like I've taught you, but again revising it. So here your delta is a trans because in conversion problem in the syllabus ahead we will study about NFA and then we are going to learn how to convert NFA to DFA. When you are going to convert NFA to DFA, that time you will have to deal with this delta. Like it will be a mathematical problem, and we are going to write multiple as a delta equations. So that time you should not be confused. So just now I am introducing a new concept of writing delta. So delta Q0 with A is equal to Q1. This way you can write down for all the transitions. Each and every transition can be represented with the help of this delta equation. Okay. So here there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 8 states. So there are 4 states. So there are 8 transitions. So we will be having 8 delta functions. For this diagram. Okay, so anyone has any doubt about delta? Can anyone repeat me what is meant by delta? Ayush Yadav? Ayush, can you unmute and tell me what is delta? If you don't know, then you can tell me that you don't know. Ayush Yadav. He's writing the answers. You can write down in the chat. Or Aditi. Sanat is saying, yeah, it is a state transition function. Delta is a state transition function. and you can write it using this equation delta q0. Q0 is the previous state or current state. In the current state, if the symbol is A, the new state is q1. How to interpret it? Q0 is a current state. In the current state of machine, if the input symbol is A, the new state is q1. So q0 comma A is equal to q1. Okay, now I think it is very simple to know. Okay, so we'll go ahead with the next problem. Now design DFA. Design DFA that accepts the language L, which is a set of words X. Here there are three symbols. X is made up of 1, 2, 3. And the question says that X begins and ends with the same letter. And the length of X is greater than 1. So what is the minimum length? Okay, anyone can tell me the interpretation. X is made up of 1, 2, 3. There are three symbols. Your string is made up of the symbols 1, 2 and 3. And your string begins and ends with the same letter. And the length of the string should be greater than 1. So the length, minimum length is 2. Write down the sample strings. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Correct. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 is allowed. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 is allowed. ठीक है. Okay. So I'll write down the definition of DFA. I'll say that sigma is equal to 1, 2, 3. Initial state is q0. Okay. Now I'll write down the answer. That minimum length string is 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Okay. Rejected input is, suppose the string is starting with 1, ending with 2, it is not allowed. Starting with 1, ending with 2 is not allowed. 2, 3 is not allowed. 2, 1. So I've listed down. Now what is allowed is that I'm writing it now in the little bit I'm going ahead to teach you about the regular expression. As I told you that DFA ka language is a regular language. And the regular language is expressed with the help of a regular expression. Okay, this is not an exact regular expression, but I'm just telling you about how it is represented. It is similar to this, it is represented. Regular expression for this language. Like it is beginning with 1, ending with 1. In between that, in between this first letter and the last letter, there can be a combination of 1, 2 and 3. Anything can be there. My string is starting with 1. If it is starting with 1, it should end with 1. In between that, there can be anything. Anything means it can be 1 or 2 or 3. And that is appearing for n number of times when my n can be 0 or 1 or 2 or 3. So n is either 0, 1, 2, 3. So if it is appearing for 0 time, my string is becoming 1, 1. So this is similar to, this is not an exact regular expression, but this is similar to the regular expression. Where I am saying that the statement is represented in the form of some equation kind of thing. Like string is of this type, starting with 1, ending with 1, in between that anything can be there. So I'm just trying to interpret it in the number format. Here it is starting with 2, ending with 2, and in between that anything can be there for n number of times. Starting with 3, ending with 3, in between anything for n number of times. Okay, so with this interpretation, I'll draw the diagram for this. Now, how can you say that how many, how to draw it? How many of final states will be there? Can anyone tell me like how to draw it for 1, 1, 2, 2 and 3, 3? My q0 is initial state. With 1, it may go to some particular state such as q1. With one more 1, it will be the final state. 1, 1 ke liye ho gaya. Then for 2, can I join to the same final state? We cannot join it because it will be a wrong answer afterwards. So, okay, first we'll draw. For 1, 1, I'll say that it is okay. So now I'm just changing the way to draw the diagram. I'll say that there are three possible combinations. From Q0, my first symbol can be either 1 or 2 or 3. Okay, so I'm drawing it like this for the first time when I'm drawing the diagram. That with 1, it may go to Q1. With 2, it may go to Q2. Because if it is starting with 1, it should end with 1. If it is starting with 2, it should end with 2. So there are different possible combinations. So I cannot have a same. I'm having three states, three different states. Now I'll say that with 1 1 it will go to the final state. Okay. Now here if for two, what should I do? In Q2, if there is two, if the string is ending with two. Yeah, so some people are saying it is Q4, some are saying Q1. Q1 to wrong, na? If with two, if it is going to Q1, with one it will end. Then it is starting with two and ending with one ho jayega. And some people are saying Q4. Q4 kiya to problem hai na? If it is Q4, then you will not get the correct answer, because for Q4 when you are drawing it for one or two, then it will not give you the correct answer. Okay, so you can try Q2 to Q4. Now in Q4 you try to think for one where it should go. So for one it will remain in the same state. So starting with one, ending with one. So Q4 mein one aa gaya, so it will remain in the Q4. And if you join Q2 to Q4, then 2 2 1 is allowed. And then you are not getting the answer. So you have to cancel everything. And then you think, you here I can think that I will have a new final state. So with 2 2 it will go to the new state, that is Q5. Yeah, so many people have answered for Q5 also. So with 2 2 I am taking a new state. Then for 3 3 also I am taking a new state. Okay, so now this is my minimum state ka diagram. So if you think that, because I told you that there is no standard method for designing, you may think that Q2 to Q4, so draw it in rough, and then you go ahead and you think about Q4, that if it is 1 or 2 or 3 what will happen, and then you check that whether it is following or fulfilling the condition. If it is not fulfilling the condition, you have to backtrack and come to the state Q2 and then think over it. And in such situation, mostly there will be a new final state. If you find out such kind of confusion, then you get the solution that there is a new final state. Okay, so like this, my minimum diagram is done now. Okay, now I'll revisit the diagram for Q0. All three transitions are done, 1, 2, 3. Because there are, my sigma contain 1, 2, 3. So I need to have three outgoing transitions, 1 for 1, 1 for 2, 1 for 3. This is there. Now in Q1, only one is done. Now 2 and 3 are remaining. So what should I do? Q1 with the symbol 2 or 3. Write in chat. In Q1 for the symbol 2 and 3. It will remain in Q1. Correct. It will remain in Q1. So with 2 and 3 it will remain in Q1. So both the symbols ka ho gaya idhar. So Q1 is also complete. Now I am going to Q4. Okay, I am going to Q2. In Q2 if there is any 1 or 3, it will remain here. Similar to that in Q3, if 1 or 2 is there, it will remain in the same state. So the transitions for Q1, Q2, Q3 are over. Now I am going to Q1. If there is any 1 in Q4, 1 in Q4, Q4. Correct. 1 in Q4 is Q4, and 2 and 3, it will go back. 2 and 3, it will go back. So that string may start like this, 1, 1, 2 and 1 should be allowed. Okay, or if it is 1, 1, 1, 2 and 1, that should be allowed. Or 1, 1, 1, 3, 1 is allowed, because starting with 1, ending with 1. Similar to that in Q5 with 2, 1, 3 it will go back, and with 2 it will remain in the final state. For Q6, 1, 2, it will go back, and 3 final state. So this was easy. Okay, so write the table final, and there are three final states. So I'm writing here F is equal to Q4, Q5 and Q6. F is a subset of, see you can verify here, F is a subset of capital Q. Capital Q may there are states Q0 to Q6. And F is a subset of Q. So F contains some of the states from Q, which are final state as per the diagram. Okay, so this is done. Now we can go, we can have one more problem. Now here I am just saying that the string begins and ends with a different letter, similar to the previous problem. But the string is beginning and ending with a different letter. Okay, so identify minimum length string. Last 5 minutes are there, so we'll solve it. String is now the same problem. Sigma is equal to 1, 2, 3, but the string is ending with ending and starting with the different letter. So identify minimum length strings. And the length of the string is greater than 1. Okay, two. What are the strings? 1, 2, 2, 3 is allowed. 2, 1, 2, 3 is okay. And 3, 2 and 3, 1 is also allowed. Okay. So you have 6 possible minimum length strings. 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 1 and 3, 2. And again, some kind of regular expression, jaisa, if I have to write down, I'll say that if it is starting with 1, it can end with 2 or 3. In between that, there can be anything. Okay, starting with 2, ending with 1 or 3, in between anything. Okay, and these are the rejected strings. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 are rejected. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, these are rejected. Okay, so start with drawing the minimum length ka diagram. It will go to Q1, then from Q1, for 2 it may go to Q2, for 3 it may go to Q3. Okay. Then I'll say that with 2 or 3 it may end to the final and it may go to the final state. If it is starting with 2, with 1 or 3 it may go to the final state. In Q3, with 1 or 2 it may go to the final state. Okay, so this is my minimum diagram is done. Now I have to identify the missing transitions. Q0 for all transitions are there. Now in Q1, if there is any one, what will happen? Where will be the transition? Q1 with 1. Reply, reply. It will be Q1 only, correct? Q1 with 1, it will Q1. So both the transitions for Q1 are done. Now in Q2, if there is any 2, it will remain there. In Q3, if there is any 3, it will remain there. So starting with 1, it will remain here only. With 2 or 3, it can go to the final state. Now in Q4, if there is any 1, it is not allowed. So it will go back. And with 2 or 3, it will remain in the final state. Like this for Q5, with 2 it will go back, with 1 and 3 it will remain there. Then with 3 it will go back and 1 and 2 it will remain there. So I think this is easy. Transition table, then final answer. The states are Q0 to Q6 and the final states are 3, Q4, Q5, Q6. Okay. So as the time is over, any doubts? If you have any doubts, you tell me. And today I'm going to post the tutorial for designing of DFA. So you need to practice a lot for designing. Okay. And tomorrow's lecture, we will solve some of the DFA problems. Okay. We will solve some more problems of DFA. And then on Friday's lecture, we will study about NFA ka design. Because DFA ka design should be thorough. So you practice it, and so I'll post the problems on as a tutorial for this particular subject. There are tutorials, so you need to do the tutorials at home. So solve all the problems and post them, the scan copy, in the classroom, Google Classroom. Okay. So today's we cannot take the quiz because it is the mathematical questions. So we'll be having the questions that you have to solve and post the scan copy. Okay, so we'll stop here.